and we will be blessed together. Welcome and God bless you. Today I will be pushing the series that we began on Sunday on building what has been left. And I will be sharing on a topic I'm calling Building Hunger for God's Word. Building Hunger for God's Word. As we come back to church, as we come back again to the sanctuary of the Lord, we saw a few last Sunday and last Sunday, but one, that many of us have lost what we used to have, the fire and the passion for the kingdom things. And therefore, in this season, as we continue building what has been left, it is important to know that there are key things that will help us to do that. And one of them is the Word of God. And tonight, as I share with us about building hunger for God's Word, I believe it is going to come to us in a fresh way. And I pray as I finish this ministry tonight, you will receive a refreshment and hunger to read and to study the Word of God. And God will bless us. So let's go to the book of, let's start with the book of Jeremiah chapter 15 and verse 16, Jeremiah 15 and verse 16. I will read. The Bible says, "When I discovered your words, I devoured them. They are my joy and my heart's delight, for I bear your name, O Lord God of heaven's armies." I repeat again. "When I discovered your words, I devoured them. They are my joy and my heart's delight, for I bear your name, O Lord God of heaven's armies." And we go back to the book of Nehemiah. I know we, for us here in Tatu Chapel, there's a Sunday we did some exposition in the book of Nehemiah. I'll be picking some scriptures from the chapter number 8 and verse 5 down to jump some verses and then go to some few verses up to verse 9. And one of the key things that we are going to see, he's the treasure that the Word of God carries. And we cannot build what has been left minus the Word of God. Because the Word of God is what raises the hunger in us for us to desire more of this Word, which is life and which brings back to living whatever is within us. We cannot worship God when our inside man is weak, and our inside man can only be strengthened by the Word of God. And the Word of God is very important when we are building our inner man, when we are trying to strengthen our spiritual life. We cannot do that minus the Word of God. And we have just read that the Word of God, the servant of God, Jeremiah says, "When I heard your words, I devoured them." He ate them. Another version says he ate them. He ate them with such a zeal. He ate them with a passion. He ate them like somebody who is very angry, somebody who wants something to eat. And therefore, tonight again, as we go to the book of Jeremiah and Nehemiah chapter 8 and verse 5 downwards, we will see the Jews when they came from Babylon and they were trying to rebuild the walls and trying to rebuild their spiritual lives too. One of the key things that had to go ahead was the Word of God. And we see in this chapter, when they came back, because there were two very significant people, we have Nehemiah and we also have Ezra. Nehemiah was like a political leader who had a burden for the work of God. But Ezra was the priest. Ezra was the religious leader. And that is why he went ahead and he read the book of the law, the Word of God to the children of to the Jews back again. And the Bible says this: Ezra stood on the platform in full view of all the people. When they saw him open the book, they all rose to their feet. Then Ezra praised the Lord, the great God, and all the people chanted, "Amen, amen," as they lifted their hands. Then they bowed down and worshipped the Lord with their faces to the ground. Let's go to verse 8. They read from the book of the law of God and clearly explained the meaning of what was being read, helping the people understand each passage. Then Nehemiah, the governor, Ezra, the priest and scribe, and the Levites who were interpreting for the people said to them, "Don't mourn or weep on such a day as this, for today is a sacred day before the Lord your God." For the people had all been weeping as they listened to the word of the law. Again, I said, when the Jews came back from Babylon, one of the things that they needed to help them as they rebuild the wall of the city, they needed to rebuild their inner man. They needed to rebuild their spiritual lives. And they began by reading the word of God. And we have seen the priest of the Lord, who was the scribe, and that is Ezra, he stood on a platform somewhere. He was visible to everybody, and he read the word of God. And one key thing we see, as he read the word of God, the Bible says they all stood. I'm sure we have seen many times the culture of our pastors telling us, let's stand as we read the word of God, because it is to be reverenced, because it is to be feared, it is to be respected, it is to be honored. And you can bear me witness, church, we have come to a place where people are no longer moved by the word of God. In fact, in churches, people celebrate when they hear more stories more than the word of God. And as ministers of the gospel and as the children of God, God is calling us to build that hunger of his word, because it carries power. And as Ezra read the word, the Bible says the people stood and they listened to the word of God as it came, as he was reading. And as he was reading, they were affirming and saying amen. And he was not just reading. Actually, when you go down in verse 8, you will see they were being explained out what the word means, and then they bowed and worshipped the Lord. This tells me that when we read and study the word of God and understand the revelation, the power, the life in the word of God, worship is going to be easy. We cannot teach the people to worship the Lord when they do not understand the word of God, because the word of God is what gives us the revelation of who is God. They give us the revelation of the love God has for us. They give us the revelation and the answers to the see things that we expect from the Lord. And they help us to connect with the love of God. And therefore, these Jews, as they were read this word and explained, again, this tells me, because they were going through the word and they were keen in some versions of the Bible, you will see they studied keenly and they were following in their Bibles as the word was being read. That means as children of God, we need to have a Bible where we are reading, and as the ministers are ministering, we are going with them word by word, reading and understanding, so that we can get the revelation behind the word of God. Blessed be the name of Jesus. And I want to say, over this season, again, you can bear me witness, very few people are taking time to read the word of God, because there has been many things that are keeping people busy. The social media, people are getting busy with other things, watching other things. They are feeding that hunger with something else, and therefore the anchor of the word of God is gone. It is no longer there. And some of them are saying, when I start to read the word of God, I sleep. When I start to read the word of God, I start dozing. But when I'm reading other things, I am okay. That tells me it is the desire of the enemy that we may be far from the word of God. But tonight, God is calling us to build the hunger for his word. Blessed be the name of Jesus. It is a season for us to arise and say, I want to delight in the word of God. I want to devour the word of God. I want to eat this word. I want to drink this word, so that we can be able to get a deeper revelation of who we are and who our God is. And as we do that, we will be able to strengthen that which remained. Blessed be the name of Jesus. And these people, again, the Bible says, as they listened to the word, they were affirming amen. They were agreeing with what the word was saying. And basically, when you read, you will see the word of God was showing these people, although they had walked from the ways of God, although they had not heard the word of God for a long time, and as a result of that, they went to disobedience. Then still God in his word, he assures them of his faithfulness. And that is why they were crying, because they were wondering, even as sinful as we are, as disobedient as we have been for those years, our God is still a faithful God. And tonight you are looking and watching at me as I bring this word. I want to tell you, and you are telling me, Pastor, every time I want to read the word of God, I just lose the interest of it. I want to tell you, unlike the food that we eat, where you eat when hunger comes, but for the word of God, the hunger comes as you read the word. The more you read it, the more you have desire to read it. The more you don't read it, the more you don't have the desire to read it. It is an opposite of what we feel in the physical hunger. And therefore tonight, as we build this hunger, then there is a call for each one of us to begin the journey to study the word of God. If you have never read through the Bible, I want to call you tonight, because the grace is sufficient tonight. It is coming upon you tonight for you to begin a journey to read the word of God. And I'm telling you the truth, when you begin this journey, you will see the miracles that will happen in your life, because the word of God is power by itself. The word of God is life by itself. The word of God, without being added anything, it is enough, and it defends itself. Blessed be the name of Jesus. And these people, as they listened to this word, the Bible says they wept, they cried, but the priests told them, Ezra, and together with Nehemiah, they told them and the Levites, please stop crying. This is a sacred day. It is a great day when we are being reminded of the faithfulness of God. Blessed be the name of Jesus. And tonight, my introduction, 3 points, I want to say this. When these Jews neglected the word of God, it brought disobedience in their life. So every time you run away from the word of God, disobedience comes your way. You automatically start disobeying because you don't know what is right and what is wrong. And the conscience that tells you this is wrong, it dies within you. But when the word of God is there, there is obedience. So when these Jews neglected the word of God, when they were in Babylon, they could not read the word. They had walked in disobedience. And as a result, their cities were destroyed. And their own lives were destroyed. And they were in sin. But thank God for Ezra. I was reading, when I was studying this word, I saw Ezra came some like 9 years earlier, months earlier than the rest of the Jews when they were coming, like in Nehemiah, when they were coming. But he had one assignment, to restore the spiritual life for these people. And he was preparing to read the word of God to these people. And he trusted God for the grace. And when he stood, the Bible says it was so clear. As he spoke the word, it left his mouth with a lot of power and grace. And it was evident in the congregation. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Point number two, the Jews were determined to return to God's work. Went to God's word. They were determined. Yes, they neglected the word when they were in Babylon. They could not read it. They walked in disobedience. Number two, we have said, they were determined to come back to return back the word of God. And they dedicated themselves into it. We saw when they came, as Ezra was reading this word, the Bible says they stood, and they stood until noon. Break of the day. They stood many hours. They dedicated themselves. Through that, we are able to see the dedication they gave to return the word of God back. And as a church and as Christians, it is a time for us to dedicate our time to bring back the word of God in our lives. Blessed be the name of Jesus. It will not come back through what the pastor is preaching on Sunday. We must get our Bibles back. And we must create time to read the word of God again. We must place some time and say, I am going to study the word of God either early in the morning or during the day or during the evening, where your time is convenient with you, as you create that time to bring back the word of God. Blessed be the name of Jesus. These people regarded this word. And as I was reading this word, preparing this message, I told myself, God, I'm praying that we come back as a church to that point, that we can reference the word of God. It is so amazing in our days, because people are using phones as the Bibles, and as a preacher is reading the word. Some people are on Facebook, because everybody thinks they are looking at the Bible. They are on Facebook, they are on WhatsApp, and they are doing their own things. But for these people, when the word was being read, they were very dedicated. They were very committed. They had that hour. They had that reference to the word. They stood and they bowed their heads down to worship the Lord because of the revelation of the word. The reason as to why the word doesn't bring revelation to us is because we read when our minds are so many things. But when you dedicate time for the word, then the word is going to come with deep revelation over your life. And number three, the word reminded them of God's faithfulness, and it brought joy and celebration. As the word came, it reminded them, even though you have not been coming to church, even though you have not been reading the word, even though things have not been working for you, I, your God, I am still committed to you as my children. The word of God reminded them of God's faithfulness, and it brought joy and celebration in their hearts. Blessed be the name of Jesus. In the book of Psalms 119, it is a chapter I love very much, and tonight I want to dedicate that chapter to you. We may not be able to read because of our time this evening, but I want you to create time and just read the entire Psalms 119. It is a book that talks about the word of God in many times, but then there is a summary. I want to give us a summary of three things that book gives us about the word of God. Number one, it tells us that God's word is true in chapter 119 and verse 142. It brings out the truth of the word of God. The word of God is true. Are you looking for truth? The other day I preached about the voice of God, and I say the voice of God is true. And one way God speaks to us is through his word. And therefore, as you read 142, it is tells us the truth of the word of God. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Allow me to read that. The Bible says, your justice is eternal and your instructions are perfectly true. Your justice is eternal and your instructions are perfectly true. It means the word of God is firmly settled in heaven. Blessed be the name of Jesus. It has truth in it, and it does not change. It does not change. And the word of God has nothing corruption in it, because it has justice in it. Are you seeking for the justice? I want to tell you tonight, the justice of God is found in his word. As you dedicate yourself to the word of God, then you will find justice in the word of God, because it is true and it is yes and amen. It changes not. Blessed be the name of Jesus. And number two, we will also see that the word of God, according to Psalms 119, it provides us with what is good. The word of God provides us with what is good. And everybody is seeking for something good. None of us is seeking for bad things. We are seeking for good things in our lives. And the Bible in verse 1 and 2, now it tells us it's the way, it is the word of God is the way to happiness. When you go and read, you will go and read those verses. We may not read them because of time. But verse 1 and 2 Psalms 119 and verse 1 and 2, it tells us the word of God is the way to happiness. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Number 2, on God's word providing good things to us, in verse 6, the Bible also points to us that the word of God is the way to avoid shame. If you do not want to go through shame, then study the word of God. You will know who you are. You will know what is meant for you and what is not meant for you. The word of God is what removes us from shame and gives us the glory that we deserve. Again, on the same point on verse 9, the word of God is the way to safety. That is why it says in verse 9 of 119. Allow me just to read that. I want to say something about verse 9 of 119. It says, how can a young person stay pure by obeying word of God? In our time when we have this generation and everybody is fearing about their children, fearing about these young people, how will they make it in this perverse generation? But one of the things we know is the word of God is the way to safety. Our children and these young people, they will be safe when they hide the word of God in their lives. As parents, as we teach our children the word of God, it will speak to them when we are not near. It will tell them no when they are away from us and they need to make some decisions in life. Again, in the same point, the word of God is the way to a good counsel according to verse 24. It is the word of God that gives us the right counsel. Many times we seek opinions of men, and sometimes they speak with their own wisdom. But because God knows our hearts, the word of God is able to test the intents of men. The word of God is able to know what pleases the Father. It is the one that gives us the right counsel. If we want to know any right counsel, then we must dip ourselves into the word of God, and we will know the right counsel of the choices and decisions we are making in life. And in verse 28, it is the word of God gives us strength. The word of God gives us strength. Every time you hear somebody say, I feel spiritually I have lost strength, I have no strength to move on, the easiest way to do it is to read the word of God. When you stand and read the word loudly by yourself, that word speaks to your spirit and your body rejuvenates. It happens to everybody. Those moments you just wake up and you feel you are so low, you feel you don't want to pray, I encourage you, learn to pick the word of God and read it loudly to yourself, and you will see the power that comes through that word to give you strength. And verse 43, it is on that same point, the word of God is the way to hope. The word of God is the way to hope. Have you lost hope in life? The word of God will renew your hope in God. It will renew your confidence to continue trusting upon the Lord. When you see your hope is gone, the only solution is to dip yourself into the word of God, because the word of God gives us hope for today and tomorrow. Hope is tomorrow. It gives us the hope to face tomorrow. And verse 98 to 100, it provides wisdom to us. And lastly, on verse 105, it is the lamp to our feet. It is the one that shows us the way to go. The word of God, it provides what is good to us. You have heard that. You can go and read those scriptures at your own time. We have seen the word of God as the answer of anything that we are seeking. Blessed be the name of Jesus. And last and not the least is... the word of God demands what is right. The word of God demands what is right. Because all the commandments of God are sure. All the commandments of God, we can read on verse 86 of the same chapter. Verse 86, all your commandments are trustworthy. They protect me from those who hand me down without cause. All the commandments of God are sure. And they are trustworthy. You can trust them. The other people can lie. Your friends can lie to you. Your spouse can lie to you. Your professors can lie to you. Your teachers can lie to you. Your pastors can even lie to you. But I want to tell you, the word of God will never lie to you. It is true. It is trustworthy. It can be trusted. And we can trust that word of God. And again, all the precepts of the law. The precepts are the law. The word of God is right. It is not wrong. Tonight, as we conclude this, about building this hunger for the word of God, I want to ask you, When was the last time you read the Bible? And when you read the Bible, what came into your heart? Because every time you read the Word of God and it doesn't move you, something is not okay in your spirit. Because the Word of God, that is what the Bible says, it is new every day. Even a verse that you have read every now and then, when you read it again, it comes with the newness of revelation. It comes with the newness of power. It comes with the newness of grace. I want to challenge us tonight. Can we create time for the Word? If you are traveling, you instead of being on WhatsApp and Facebook, you can download the Bible and read the Bible. For those who drive, you can buy the audio Bibles and you put it, the whole Bible, in your flash disk. You can go listening. There are tapes that you can buy and you can listen to the Word of God as you drive. For the parents who are watching me tonight, even as we invest the Word of God in our children, instead of those children watching the cartoon, like now we have shops that sell packages of the Bible stories and they have the Bible in it, and you can have them, those you can have those discs for your children so that they can listen to the Word of God. They can delight in the Word of God. They can love the Word of God. And tonight, as we close, Hebrews 4 and 12, verse 12, the Bible says, the Word of God is living and active, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing to the division of the soul and the spirit, of joints and the marrow, discerning the thoughts and the intents of the heart of man. And tonight, when you treasure the Word of God, you will be a man who has wisdom. When you treasure the Word of God, you have life with you. When you treasure the Word of God, you will be able to make decisions in life without fear, because the Word of God clearly is able to separate and tell you this is right, this is not right. As we close, I challenge us again. Can we create and build hunger for the Word of God by reading the Word more and more and more? Studying the Word more and more. If you have never read the Bible, the whole of the Bible, before Corona is over, you have a chance, you have an opportunity to say, I am going to begin and I will run this marathon. And I'm telling you the truth, you will never be the same again. Some of us, even a day goes without reading the Bible. Others, a week goes without reading the Bible. And on Sunday, that is when we are looking for the Bible where it is. And when we go to church, even when the pastor is reading the Bible, you don't read the Bible. Even if we have the electronic projections, it is good to have your Bible and read the Bible. Our pastor, our senior pastor, encourages us, even if you have the electronic Bible, please make sure that you have the paper Bible. There is a way it has, I don't know whether it is me who feels that, I have the electronic Bibles, but there is a way this Bible, when you read it, the paper Bible, you just feel special power and grace come upon you. It is the Bible like any other, but this Bible is so powerful. The Word of God, building anger for the Word of God. As I conclude, and you're watching me online, I want you to raise your hand wherever you are seated. I want to pray and declare, because like a natural hunger, it is given, it is naturally given by God. And therefore, this spiritual hunger for the Word of God, God releases it by grace. How I pray that as you raise those hands, you will trust God for special anointing tonight, for special grace tonight, that you will receive and you will study the Word of God without struggle. You will not dance again as you read the Word of God. You will not be bored to read the Word of God. You will not get bored when the pastor is reading the Word of God. You will not be bored when you see somebody read the Word of God. Instead, there will be that desire. There will be that passion. And as I pray, believe God for this grace tonight. Father, in Jesus' mighty name, I want to thank you because of the Word. It is short, but you have spoken to us about building the hunger of your Word. We cannot build what remains without the Word. And therefore, tonight, in Jesus' name, I want to declare the restoration of the the passion and the hunger of the word of God upon the church of Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus, we will not be bored to read the word of God. We will not be discouraged to read the word of God. We will not lose interest as we read the word of God. We will read it with reference in the mighty name of Jesus. We will experience the power behind every verse that we read. We will experience the anointing behind every word that we will read in the name of Jesus. And therefore tonight I release that grace for those who are trusting you to read the word of God and to go through the entire Bible in the mighty name of Jesus. Not just reading, but having a deep revelation, having meditation of your word in the mighty name of Jesus. We will speak your word. We will testify your word. We will sing songs of your word in the mighty name of Jesus. When we dream, we will dream the word of God in the mighty name of Jesus. Even when we greet, we shall greet with the word of God, because you shall fill our hearts with your word. You shall fill our hearts with your hunger and thirst, oh God, for this is what will usher in the presence of God, and it will then usher in the revival that you are speaking about in the body of Christ. Father, we thank you. We honor you. I also pray for those who are sick. May they receive healing in Jesus' mighty name. Those who are trusting God for financial breakthrough, I declare open doors in Jesus' mighty name. I declare those who are trusting you for opportunities, our God, you will come through for them in the mighty name of Jesus. I invoke the power of your word that says silver and gold belongs to you, and declare you shall release it unto them in the mighty name of Jesus. I speak your blessings upon your people tonight and declare, Jehovah God of glory, a transformation is taking place tonight as we receive the grace to study and to read your word. We thank you and we bless you. For this we pray in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. The Lord bless you. The Lord bless you. We love you and we appreciate you. For those who are online, the Lord bless you. And the Lord minister that grace for you to study the word of God in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.